Our first film is Broken Arrow, and this is an action picture that's simply a lot of fun most of the way, even though it doesn't add up to much. Not a ringing endorsement, but I liked it. John Travolta stars as a top Air Force pilot who, unbeknownst to his co-pilot, Christian Slater, and their commanding officer, has masterminded a plot to hijack and ransom a couple of thermonuclear bombs that are aboard the stealth bomber he's assigned to take for a test ride in the Utah desert.
Palmdale's concerned about low-level gamma and X-ray diffusion screwing up the peripherals. They want to send up a couple on a pre-dawn run. See if anything glows.
61s?
Big ones. 83s.
Phew. Crowd pleasers.
After scuttling the plane and seemingly getting rid of Slater, Travolta meets with the money man behind the hijacking. He's played by Bob Gunton.
Look, Mr. Pritchett, I will deliver the weapons to the destination. But I can't depend, and I can't guarantee pay.
What if they don't?
Well, if they don't, the Southwest will be a quiet neighborhood for about 10,000 years.
Of course, Slater has survived the plane crash, and he joins forces with a pretty Utah Park Ranger, Samantha Mathis, to try to defeat Travolta and his crew. This is a typical high-energy scene directed by Hong Kong filmmaker John Woo in his second Hollywood feature. And here's more action as the fight between Slater and Travolta is complicated by the presence of the bombs.
Would you mind not shooting at the thermonuclear weapons?
Instead of a constantly intriguing story, Broken Arrow offers us colorful characters, Travolta and his crew, against Slater and Mathis. The action gets a little long in the tooth, I think, in a mine shaft and then later on a train, but director John Woo keeps things moving with enough fresh visuals to hold our attention. On that basis, I like Broken Arrow.
I didn't like it, Gene. In fact, I was quite disappointed in it, and you put your finger on some of the things I didn't like. It goes on too long.
Yes.
It's just one special effect after another, and it's boring because the story is not interesting, and the characters are not sharply drawn, and Travolta does not make a convincing villain.
He's a sweet guy.
He is.
And that's why he's a star.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't work. You know, as you say this, I don't think I've ever done this on this show in 20 years, but I'm going to twist my thumb. I'm going to go just like this. Because
I talked you into it?
Well, listen, it was a half-hearted endorsement.
Yeah, it was.
But right at the top, I don't normally say half-hearted. And what am I really defending here? I'm defending some colorful action scenes, and they are colorful action scenes. And the rotor blade, I thought, you know, this is a lot of fun that we just saw. But really, I can't recommend
it. It's not up there. There is a craft of action pictures that's up in this level.
Okay.
This movie just doesn't quite.
I'm changing my opinion now.
I'm amazed.
Do me one. No,
I'm amazed.
I know you're amazed. Okay. Do me one favor.
Yeah.
Look in the camera and say I was wrong about Cop and a Half. It wasn't a very good movie. Burt Reynolds.
No, I won't do that.
What?
No, no, no. I won't do that. I saw things in Cop and a Half.
Yeah,
that I admired.
That no one else did.
Okay. Well, in any event, you've done a very good thing, and I've also done a good thing too by sticking to my gun.